excited about this site that we have today.
What site is that?
We're talking about free movies, baby. Oh, yes. Because I don't know if you've been to the movie theater lately.
I haven't.
But these movies run $8.50, $9. I mean, ridiculous.
Wait, and that's part of the reason I have not gone.
Right. I mean, my husband and I might go $20. Forget about it if we wanted to take a friend or a cousin.
Yeah.
So, ridiculous.
And you have to eat popcorn.
Well, yeah.
Drink a soda.
So that's $40 just to
huge,
go see.
Big a big soda, a big popcorn.
Oh, no, our soda for, you know, $5.
$4, yeah.
Right, what are you talking about? Forget about it. Yeah. So, being that I've been around such wonderful technology geniuses as yourself and Jeff and all those here at Palm Breeze Cafe, I have been introduced to a wonderful site called snagfilms.com. And this site allows us to be able to view full-length feature movies for what?
Free.
Yes, that's exactly right. So let's take a look at the site.
Let's do it.
So snagfilms.com basically has, they like to focus on a lot of documentaries, but there are other things that are on the site as well. And basically they just have a library of videos that you can click on and you can press play and you can watch the entire movie. So let's look, there's a couple of ways you can search through it, but let's go over here to the search, the top right. We're going to, let's say Super Size Me. I like that movie. That's a documentary about, you know, the effects that the food, McDonald's food has on the body.
And eating, like we just said, at the movie theater with those
right,
the popcorn.
Exactly,
and, yeah.
Exactly. So we're going to click on it here, and as you can see, this is the cover of it. And once you click on it, it just downloads it right there into your window. And then, of course, the beginning of the documentaries usually have a small advertisement of some sort.
Okay, so this is not actually downloading to your computer. This is actually streaming it.
That's correct. And basically, after it gets through this little advertisement. And
always got to have an ad.
Right, always has an advertisement. Then it actually will play, it'll start the movie, the documentary film for you. And you just press play, and of course, you can sit down on your computer and watch the entire.
So you probably want to have a DSL line here.
Right, yes.
This is not for the weak-hearted.
It's not for the weary. It's not for, I got a computer last week and I just plugged it into my telephone line.
Yeah,
probably not going to be that effective for you. But it's really kind of cool because you can go here to watch the film or you can go to snag the film. And that's kind of one of the, let's stop this here.
Business specialists at Verizon Wireless.
Oh, they probably stop you from pausing it while the advertising is on there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
But as you scroll down a little bit, I can see where you can actually snag it. You can, what can you do? There's all those options down there?
Yes, there are all the options that are down here. So in other words, let's say I wanted to email this movie to my friend. All I would do is click on email, and then I would put in two, after I add them to my contacts, I put in two, from, and any comments that I have for that. And then once I just press send, and then my friend, whoever I sent it to, will have access to the movie.
That's
so
great.
They'll get a link and they'll be able to come and stream it, and of course they'll
That's
be able
great.
To get
And it is
get
always
that.
A good idea to add comments when you do that, because otherwise I think people think, you know, this is some kind of spam coming through,
right?
And that way they know this is okay, it's coming from a friend, and this is why the friend is sending it, so
right.
It's always a good idea to
do
that when you send that kind of email.
And again, like you were saying, with the when you go to the Snag channel, it had email, or you could send it to someone's Facebook, you could send it to a blog, you
that's
can
great.
Embed it in
really?
Your own in your own website.
Okay.
So there's all different types of things that you can do, so it's not just an independent, I want to read this movie, I want to look at this movie myself, I can actually share the movies for whatever various purposes
well,
I might have.
That's a great idea. Like, you can take Super Size Me, and if you're talking about nutrition in the classroom,
right.
That's a great way to, for example, take the embed code and throw it into like Edline,
right.
And then you can share it with your classroom, and you can engage in discussion with your kids
right.
about, you know, let them watch the movie, and then you can talk some more about nutrition.
And I think it's really interesting because I know a lot of times we take time to show films in school, and it takes away from the instructional time, the discussion time. But if you can get your permission slips and have the parents be okay with the students watching this particular film, they can actually look at it at home on their computer,
sure.
And then the next day that you can maximize the instructional time.
That's true.
Because the students have already looked at this piece of video
right.
And now they can discuss and have some, or they can write about it or things of that nature.
Right.
So it really does allow you to capitalize on that, whereas otherwise you might not have been able to do that because
right.
you just didn't have the technology
and
to
you're
kind
not
of
using
support that.
So much time in the classroom
that's
watching
right.
the video, because
that's
going to, I would imagine that's an hour and a half long, Super
right.
Size Me, probably.
Right, and it might take, what, 3 days in the classroom, whereas the students, you may be able to assign it over 2 nights of homework,
sure.
And then you can have those discussions in class and really make that powerful learning.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's really a really good application for that, and I think it's interesting because if you are a documentary filmmaker, you know, that you can actually submit a film to be posted to snagfilms.com. They have criteria, but it's not extensive to the point of prohibitive. So they tell you what the criteria are, and even if you have participated in a festival or something of that nature, and you can submit it and actually have your film, your documentary, posted to their library.
Wow.
So it's a good way of able to get your films distributed.
That's great. I think digital storytelling is really coming on board in classrooms.
Mm-hmm.
And what a great way for students to see some purpose with their work.
Exactly. I also like the collaborative part to this, because I'm not going to click on the film again because I don't want it to run its advertisement. Mm-hmm. But when you click on the film, you can go down a little further. Let's go back to home. Let's see what we can click on one of the task bars that talks about most discussed right here.
Oh, so there's a forum.
Yes. So they have films that when people click on the films, they read the films and they actually will post comments to the website.
Nice.
So if you're interested in having a discussion about a particular film, you can go right here, click on the film that you're interested in doing, and you can actually post your comments and have an online discussion about the film that you're watching, which makes it very interactive. So you're not just, you know, kind of receiving knowledge, you'd be able to interact with other people who are interested in the same film.
Because how often have you seen a film and then you want to talk about it some more?
At the end of every movie, I'm kind of like, well, what did you think about this? You know,
I don't usually wait till the end. I'm one of those people who like to talk about it while it's going on.
Leah,
you're
one of those.
Yeah. What did he mean by that? What did he just say? I'm usually the one getting shushed.
Exactly.
I guess that's why I don't go to movies very often. No one will go with me.
That might be something. Maybe you need to remember the milk and to remind yourself
no talking during the movies.
I think another really cool part of this is that you can actually create a movie theater on your own website. Embed a widget into your own web page from this. Let's see if I can get to show you how to do that. Let's see. And if we go over here to the right, it says take any of our films with you.
Put a movie theater on your page. Wow.
And it's very simple to do. It gives you the steps by steps of how to do it. Basically, you go to browse the films that you want. You can either go through the entire list, or you can search by title or keyword like we did earlier with Supersize Me. Once you decide which films that you want, you can choose up to 5 films. And then you can name your widget, for example, whatever the topic is on your web page. And then you can preview your widget, and then you can actually embed that onto your web page. And then when it goes to that widget, it'll actually have all 5 of those films available to be played and viewed completely by
anybody. So you can actually have your students choose from the films.
That's
nice, because a lot of sites that offer you that kind of widget, they don't allow you to choose the films.
Right.
They allow you to just, you know, embed the widget, but then they feed the content to you.
So this does allow you, and it's great because you can set up different pages on different topics, the things that you're interested in learning or teaching.
Nice.
So it's really good. I really like snagfilms.com. This is the beta version, so there are going to be some more improvements. So if you got some hiccups, that's just kind of what it is. But it's a great tool, so save yourself some money in these hard economic times and get some free films at snagfilms.com. And we'll be back with more Palm Brief.